refrigeration to refrigeration. So try to do them last. You know, remember cheese can always be frozen in smaller packages. Bread can be in the refrigerator also and last a little bit longer. So when you're storing your foods, refrigerate your perishables immediately. Fruits and vegetables, you know, go ahead and wash them off, get them in the freezer, wash them off or in the refrigerator. Clean your poultry before putting it in the refrigerator, wash and clean it. Especially if it's not going to be cooked for a couple days. You know, your packages and your cans, you know, put them away for your folks. Kind of rotate them, you know. If there's some leftovers of cans or something from a previous week, bring them forward so the newer ones are basically in back. In your meal preparation, a lot of it's going to be microwave cooking or basically oven cooking, possibly a stove cooking. Stay there with it, especially stove and oven. Watch stuff for getting burnt, watch stuff for getting too hot, watch things for, you know, especially during the hot summers and things like that. You know, be aware of the folks' electric bill, especially during peak alerts and things like that. If you're doing baked potatoes, make sure you wash them real well for them. You know, your microwave is great for leftovers, for reheating. Frozen vegetables a lot of times have to be defrosted first. Meats, you know, seem to taste better when they're cooked. Traditional methods on top of the stove just doesn't quite taste the same in a microwave, you know. Now you may, you know, help your folks get onto Meals on Wheel program also. Remember that is also available for your folks. Watch your folks for food allergies. Like I said, gluten and lactose are probably your biggest, but there's preservatives and dyes also. In your food preparation, do a variety of different foods for your folks. Make it look good. Different colors, make it appearance colorful, flavorful with a good aroma, you know, and satisfy their hunger, satiety, and of course balance, you know. On 183 it talks about traditional ethnic, regional, and racial food kind of patterns and preferences. You can kind of read through this. Chinese folks, African American, Jewish, Italian, Puerto Rican, Near Eastern, Greek, and Mexican. If your folks are on a therapeutic diet, you know, be aware of that. Your case manager will talk to you about that. But on 195, it talks about some of the different diets there. Low calorie for, you know, for overweight folks to lose weight. High calorie for folks trying to gain weight. And good calories. Peanut butter, eggnog, you know, ice cream, good calories. Bland diet for people with the heartburn issues. Diabetic for, you know, the people that need their sugar controlled. Low sodium, mostly that's going to be your heart patients with a tendency toward fluid overload with a lot of edema. Low cholesterol, low fat, those are going to be your folks with, of course, you know, heart problems again that were caused by fat clots and things like that. You know, remember when you were, you know, helping folks eat and things like that and feeding clients, remember the big thing is couple of bites, about half of the teaspoon, alternated with liquids. Remember, they, you know, the salivary glands are just not there like they used to if they're older clients. So you've got to give them a few bites and then alternate with a liquid. On 198, it shows you several of the different types of appliances or eating devices. You know, sippy cup, built-up fork handles, curved fork, a plate guard, different things that help folks. And of course, you've seen that in CNA class before. And then, like it ends on page 199 with folks with, my alarm's going to go off here, so I'm just going to let it do it. Folks with feeding tubes, and it shows you a picture there of a feeding tube. You know, now that you probably, you know, will not be disconnecting and connecting and changing their rate or anything like that. That is, you know, in the in the scope of practice for an LP and for an RN, okay? But the one thing that a lot of people forget about is that folks that are on these liquid diets in bed, the head of the bed needs to be up about at least 30 to 40 degrees. If I had a cup of water here and I laid it down like this, you know what's going to happen. It's going to spill out everywhere, right? Well, that's the same thing in the stomach. We need to have their head up like this so the liquid stayed down the stomach. If they were to lay flat on their back, possibly just like my cup of water, it's going to spill out. The food will come up the esophagus, and as they breathe, they'll suck it right down to their lungs. So you have them elevated the hair of the bed, but then remember there's going to be more weight on the bottom. So watch their bottoms and teach your families to also watch their bottoms for sores. Okay, that ends this lecture right here.